This is the Atlas 4 from Flyfish RC. It's a 4-inch ultralight drone, which can be built under 250 grams, which means it flies under the drone registration rules in most countries. But this ultralight design is not just about sticking it to the man. I really like ultralights like this because you can get some nice long flights on relatively small batteries. They don't make a lot of noise, so you can get away with flying something like this in a place where you might not be able to fly something bigger and heavier. And with the DJI O3 on board, you get some super high quality 4K footage. And best of all, this drone is pretty cheap. It's available as a frame kit or as a bundle that comes with a frame, motors, and props for something like 80 bucks. I did build up this drone myself, but if you don't like the idea of building a drone and you'd rather buy something that's pre-built, you might want to consider the Gep RC Turn LR40. That's my favorite 4-inch bind and fly right now, and I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Now, Flyfish RC is not sponsoring this video. I did pick up the Atlas 4 and all the parts that you'll see in this video myself, and the reason is that I wanted to build a 4-inch ultralight that I can use as a travel or hiking companion. In this video, I'm gonna give you guys a real close look at this drone. I'll show you my build and how I put it together, and I'll give you guys some tips on doing a build that's under 250 grams. Please make sure you're subscribed, and if you have any questions or comments, let me know in the comments section. I always get back to you guys down there. All right, let's get into it. The Atlas 4 comes in a bag like this, not a box, but considering the price point, you get very good value for money with this frame. I have tons of hardware left over after building up my drone, and a lot of that hardware is pre-thread locked, and you do have countersunk screws, which I really appreciate because it gives the drone a more finished look overall. The arms are 3.5 millimeters thick, and the top plate and bottom plates are 1.5 millimeters thick. I don't see myself breaking any arms because this quad is so lightweight, although those top and bottom plates are pretty thin, but that's the trade-off you make for an ultralight design. You do get two different sets of silicone camera inserts, so you can run either 19 millimeter or 20 millimeter FPV cameras. For motors, you have both 9 millimeter and 12 millimeter mounting holes, and you have two sets of 20 millimeter and 25 millimeter mounting holes available in the middle for your stack and in the rear for your VTX. You do get loads of TPU parts, even including a GoPro mount, but if you're interested in doing a sub 250 gram build, you're gonna have to make some tough choices on which TPU parts you want to include. Even though this is a sub 250 gram frame, if you're willing to go over 250 grams, it makes a great long range drone with larger batteries and even a lightweight travel filming drone with something like a GoPro Bones. You'll notice I have some foam landing feet on mine instead of the TPU landing feet. It's because I had to remove the TPU in order to hit that 250 gram weight limit. Flyfish RC does have a detailed instruction sheet on how to assemble this frame, but it doesn't come in the package. You have to look for it on their support pages and print it out if you want to have a printed copy. For my build, I'm using the Flyfish RC 1804 2450 motors. For reference, my Gep RC Croc 4 came with 1404 2750 motors. 1804s are not small for an ultralight quad like this, and this quad could very easily carry an ultralight action camera like a naked GoPro, an Insta 360 Go, or even a GoPro Bones. With these 2450 kV motors, I will be flying my Atlas 4 on 6S batteries. Flyfish RC does have these 1804s in a higher kV that's intended for 4S. Now with 6S batteries, my setup is gonna go over 250 grams. I don't have any 6S batteries that are small enough or light enough to make that 250 gram weight limit, although Flyfish RC does say that with 380 milliamp 6S, you can get under 250 grams. I don't own any of those, so I'm just gonna accept that I'm gonna go over 250 grams when I'm on 6S batteries. I will be weighing my setup for you in just a minute. I am using a 20 by 20 stack. This is a Diatone F722 Mark IV. I'm using this stack mostly because I already had it in my parts drawer. If you're planning on doing a sub 250 gram build, I would highly recommend using an all-in-one board to save a few grams. Let me show you guys something I noticed installing my stack. The frame does have mounting for a 20 by 20 millimeter stack or a 25 by 25 millimeter all-in-one board, but there are press nuts pre-installed into the bottom plate, which are so close to the 20 millimeter holes that they interfere a little bit with my stack screws. I'm not sure if you guys can see that. I'll give you a close-up shot, but I had to use some extra rubber grommets to make sure that my stack wasn't off center. It's pretty clear that Flyfish RC designed this frame for an all-in-one board. So even though the 20 by 20 millimeter holes are there, I recommend going with an all-in-one board. I am using a Flyfish RC mini GPS unit, which drops right into the included mount. It might not be the most effective M10 GPS unit on the market, but it gets satellites pretty well, especially considering that it's cheap, it's tiny, and it only weighs like 2.5 grams. I did use a pre-shielded GPS wire from Diatone to shield the GPS from interference from the VTX. I am using a Beta FPV Super D diversity receiver. You can see my diversity antennas mounted on the arms, and I've got my receiver mounted back here, tucked underneath the arms so it's protected. There really was nowhere else for me to put the receiver, but I think this works out just fine. Normally I'd use Crossfire or even 915 megahertz ELRS, but I didn't like the way the antennas fit into this rear mount. They would have been shoved underneath the carbon in these arms, and I didn't like that very much. This diversity ELRS setup should give me a strong, reliable signal and all the range I would ever want. I am using the DJI O3 air unit, of course, and I'm also using a Flyfish RC extended antenna. That does cost me an extra gram or two in weight, but for me, the extra video reception is worth it. Now the frame does come with these spacers for installing your DJI O3, but I used a mounting solution from Lumineer. These aluminum mounting plates for the DJI O3 have the advantage of raising up the O3 just enough for me to route all of my wires and cables underneath. That gives the build a nice, clean, finished look. All right, you guys, with this 550 milliamp high voltage 4S battery, my build weighs in at 249.9 grams. I literally came down to the last 10th of a gram, and I am using a battery that's smaller than what I'd like to use, and I left out a bunch of these TPU parts. To hit that magic number, you have to think of weight like a currency. You have to spend the weight on the things that are most important to you, like a bigger battery or a better antenna. In my case, I used a 20 by 20 stack that I already had, a diversity receiver. I used these rear TPU mounts, relatively large motors, and each of those trade-offs were worth it to me, but that meant that in order to hit that 250 grams, I had to use a smaller battery than what I'd like to use and a super simple battery strap. I'll also be using this 3000 milliamp 4S lithium ion pack and this 850 milliamp 6S pack. Now with these packs, there's no way to get this quad under 250 grams, but I will get some nice long flight times and I'll have the option to carry a GoPro Bones. For my maiden flight, I headed out to a model airplane field where I like to test a new build just in case anything goes wrong. It's an area where I would be able to recover the drone if it crashed. After these initial tests, I did head out to another location that's a little more scenic. There's a waterfall there, and you'll see some of those B-roll shots throughout the video. For these test flights, I did stay within a kilometer so that my spotter could maintain visual line of sight. Although this drone is capable of flying true long range, I'm running the Flyfish RC 1804 2450 kV motors, which are 6S motors. I intend to fly my Atlas 4 on 6S batteries, but when I do that, it'll be over 250 grams. Now, 4S batteries work perfectly fine on these 6S motors for cruising and endurance flights, but I did have to be a little bit higher in the throttle. If you plan to fly mostly 4S batteries, Flyfish RC does have these 1804 motors available in 3500 kV, which is gonna be a much better choice for 4S. On my sub 250 gram setup, which means a 4S 550 milliamp battery, I was able to get about 4 minutes. Now keep in mind, my batteries are older and I didn't charge them over 4.2 volts, even though they are capable of being charged up to 4.35 volts. I was just charging a pile of batteries before I headed out and I forgot to change the settings on my charger. Also, keep in mind that my build is not the lightest. I'm using that 20 by 20 stack instead of an all-in-one board. I'm using relatively heavy motors and several TPU parts that aren't strictly necessary. And if you're flying sub 250, every gram counts. I also flew my 854S batteries, which brings my Atlas IV just over 250 grams, but it gave me some nice 6-minute flight times, and I didn't have to worry about voltage sag as much on those slightly larger cells. 850 to 1000 milliamps really does feel like the sweet spot with this quad because you're getting a little bit longer flight times, but it's still nice and lightweight. I also flew my 3000 milliamp lithium ion packs, which gave me over 14 minutes just cruising around. I did get that 14 minutes by charging only up to 4.1 volts and charging down to about 3.2. I think I was closer to 3.1 or 3.15 when I landed. You could definitely fly longer if you're willing to push your batteries a little bit harder. With lithium ion packs, this is an awesome micro long range setup. You can cruise around and get some amazing scenery shots with that DJI O3. And since this Atlas IV is still pretty lightweight, it doesn't make very much noise. Although I do have to tell you guys that on my 6S motors, the power with this 4S lithium ion pack just wasn't really there, especially by the end of the pack when the voltage got super low. I almost put the quad on the runway when I came in to land because I just forgot how saggy this quad would be at those low voltages. Now this shouldn't come as a surprise running a lower voltage 4S lithium ion pack on 6S motors with those Flyfish RC 1804 3500 kV motors, it would be a completely different story. I finally put on my 6S 850 packs, which is really what I built this quad for. With these lightweight 6S packs, this quad absolutely screams. The combination of a lightweight build with 6S power is awesome. And of course, 6S is what I built this quad for. It's what these motors were designed for. Running 4S was really just for the sake of doing a sub 250 gram build. On an 850 6S pack, the power to weight ratio is insane and the quad feels great. And best of all, you get some amazing efficiency. I was easily getting over 8 minutes of flight time and I wasn't even really trying to conserve my battery. I think I got close to 9 minutes on one of my flights. If you want your Atlas IV to rip, it will definitely do that on 6S, but naturally you'll get a little bit less flight time. For me, this is the exact setup that I was aiming for this build. A lightweight 4-inch quad with 1804 motors on 6S batteries is plenty efficient to get some nice long flight times, but it's powerful enough to rip if you want it to, or in my case, what I really want is to be able to carry a lightweight camera like a GoPro Bones. That makes this quad the perfect travel companion. It's lightweight, it'll fly forever, it doesn't make a lot of noise, and on 6S batteries, the power is there. All right, you guys, let me tell you what I like and don't like about the Atlas IV. It's a dead cat frame, which means you won't get props in view with your DJI O3 footage. I really like dead cat frames because for me, it's all about those cinematic FPV shots. The price point is also very good at $37. The bundle on Flyfish RC's website that comes with motors and props for 80 bucks is a great deal. It's nice that you get loads of TPU parts, including one for that Nano GPS. I highly recommend the Flyfish RC Nano GPS. It's cheap, it works pretty well. I'm not gonna say it's the best GPS on the market, but it's a good choice when it comes to weight and cost. I do like that they include so many TPU prints out of the box. Even though you won't use them all if you're trying to build sub 250, the fact that they're included means that Flyfish RC solves many of the problems that you have with a new FPV build. How am I gonna route my battery lead? How am I gonna mount my GPS? How am I gonna mount my antenna? Those TPU prints solve most of those problems for you. What makes this frame a really good value is all the extras. You get two different sets of rubber dampeners for your FPV camera. You get two different battery pads. You get tons of extra hardware, and that hardware is pre-threadlocked. And the countersunk screws are a really nice touch. Flyfish RC has been killing it lately with their Volador frames, and the Atlas 4 is the 4-inch ultralight to beat this year. All right, you guys, let me know if you have any feedback in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.